In this video, we will look at the most meaningful news for the 6 publicly traded air taxi and advanced air mobility companies for the year 2023 up to Christmas Day. And let's start with Archer. In August, Archer, Wisk, and Boeing made headlines by reaching an agreement to settle litigation while also entering into an autonomous flight collaboration. Additionally, Boeing disclosed an investment in Archer. Although executives from all parties lauded this as a win-win deal, a closer look at the specifics reveals a unidirectional flow of money from Archer to Wisk, either presently or in the future. On the other hand, the autonomous flight collaboration is actually a commitment from Archer to making Wisk its exclusive provider for autonomy. This settlement means that Archer can fully focus now on delivering on its promises to its investors and to the public. Having Boeing attorneys all over you is far from ideal. It also implies that the executives and board members are willing to give away shares and dilute existing shareholders in order to settle lawsuits and God knows what else. The agreement also implies a binding association with Wisk as the sole autonomy provider. In an industry where unanimous agreement exists regarding the critical role of autonomy for sustained financial viability, is such a vendor lock a good thing? That remains an open question. For a detailed breakdown of the settlement terms, check out the link at the end of this video. EHang announced in October that its EH216-S had obtained the type certificate from the Civil Aviation Administration of China, that it was the world's first type certificate for unmanned electric vertical takeoff and landing aircraft, and that it not only sets a benchmark for the airworthiness certification of innovative eVTOLs in China and overseas, but it also serves as an epoch-making milestone for commercial urban air mobility operations. The stock shot almost 50% after this announcement. However, a critical caveat comes with this achievement. The EH216-S is not authorized for flights in urban environments. Its operational scope is limited to sparsely populated areas, essentially ruling out urban settings. So why is it the most meaningful news for EHang? Well, it is because of how the specialized press dealt with it. Instead of taking the time to look at the nuances, many specialized outlets sensationalized this achievement without scrutinizing the specifics outlined in the very same type certificate. This oversight led to portraying this development as a historic breakthrough in the industry, contributing to misleading headlines and misguided enthusiasm. In an industry that is highly technical, highly regulated, and full of acronyms, investors can be easily sucked into a stock based on attention-grabbing headlines just to watch their position go down the drain. My advice? Filter out the noise and take the time to do your own research if you do not have a background or connections in the aerospace industry. Eve Air Mobility, I looked twice, nothing meaningful to report. Their communication department has been busy putting out 22 press releases on their website, but nothing meaningful for investors. Vertical Airspace received a continued listing standard notice from NYSE due to its shares trading below $1 for over 30 consecutive days. This exemplifies the struggle faced by this company. After a period of high volatility, the stock tanked and has remained below the dollar mark since the end of October, with a cash position of less than $100 million, clearly insufficient to fund their program through completion. The company has announced its intention to raise up to $100 million through mixed securities, further adding to the stock's struggle. This is a comparison of their stock in relation to Joby and Archer, and it reveals a stark contrast. I mean, there is no comment to make here. Long-term financial resources are crucial in successfully introducing a new aircraft to the market, and Vertical Airspace is learning this lesson the hard way. None of Vertical Airspace's announcements have managed to stop the downward trajectory of their stock price. None. In September, Joby achieved a significant milestone by delivering its first aircraft to Edwards Air Force Base, 6 months ahead of schedule. Joby not only talks the talk, but walks the walk by meeting its commitments. With aspirations to lead the market, Joby is diligently striving to be the first mover, demonstrating a level of dedication that is commendable. This achievement marks a significant moment, not just for Joby, but for the entire air taxi industry, making it the most meaningful news of the year for Joby Aviation. In October, Lilium signed an agreement with an aircraft broker to open the private sales of its jets for individuals in the US market. This announcement is consistent with Lilium's commercial strategy to start in the premium market. With a price tag of $10 million, the Lilium jet is destined to early adopters and aviation enthusiasts who can afford it. The agreement is for 5 jets only, so how fast these aircraft will sell will be interesting to follow, and this will serve as a validation of Lilium's commercial strategy, and therefore an important metric if you are contemplating an investment in Lilium. 5 jets, it is not a big number, so they should sell fast in theory. That's it for this video, and see you in the next one.